Thank you, Linda. Thank you, audience. My task today is to look on the same issue that we are all discussing from a totally different perspective. Because mostly we've been talking about those countries and regions that are that are not part of European Union, for example, that are in Southeast Europe, Eastern neighbors, Central Asia. But my main point today would be that those regions, those countries, EU member states as well, have a lot to learn from the experience of those countries that as recently as 10 years ago were not part of European Union, but right now have already had some 6 years, some 8 or 9 years to integrate within the structures of European Union. And in my opinion, that experience has been quite inspiring, and I will share with you some preliminary observations from research that we have just started, and that will be ongoing throughout next year. But already now we can see some experience from those new EU member states that could be in use when we think also about Southeast Europe, Eastern neighbors and Central Asia as well. So first of all, the new EU member states, and what I mean by new EU member states is those member states that have acceded to European Union in 2004 or later. How they feel right now here in European Union. If we look at this group as a category and see how the population responds in those countries to the same questions as the population of older member states, older member states are required to respond, then we see that there are some substantial differences. Some are positive differences, like, for example, new EU member states tend to trust the European Union more. They also see it in a better light. They believe more often that things are going in the right direction. And in general, they see a better future for the EU, for the European Union, than the average of older member states do. So that's quite an optimistic picture, because this shows that the new EU member states have not been disillusioned from the process of joining the European Union or from being there, even though our own survey that we did in 4 specific members, new member states, showed that the level of trust is quite low if you look at it from absolute numbers. But if we compare it to the older member states, then it's still higher. So new EU member states bring more optimism to European Union. There are certain problems as well. If we compare new European Union member states and older European Union member states, we see that the older member states have a clearer sense of belonging to European Union citizenship. They are more likely to respond that they feel as citizens of European Union. They also discuss European Union matters more frequently with their friends and relatives, which probably mean that they feel more engaged in European Union matters, and that they also feel that they can exert more influence in European Union, both as citizens and as member states. So in this respect, there is still some way to go for new EU member states, despite already being in this club for a certain amount of years. But there are no distinct differences regarding the knowledge on the basic institutional structure of the European Union between the older member states and new member states. We've also tried to look at some of the accession countries and see whether there are any distinct differences between these three groups: new member states, old member states, and those countries that are in the process of accession to European Union. And some of the most important findings that I would like to share with you is that there is very slight, sometimes even inexistent, difference between the knowledge in the population of those countries on how the European Union functions. For example, in Montenegro, the level of knowledge about European Union in greater population is the same as both in new member states of and old member states. And also, what is interesting is that for the accession countries, European Union is seen even in more positive light than for new member states or any member states in European Union. And I will explain a bit later why it matters, and why it matters also for Central Asia and those countries that are not even in an accession stage. What we have learned during interviews with representatives of those new European Union member states, and also people working in Brussels, in European Parliament, in Economic and Social Committee, in permanent representations and in other institutions, is that it's quite a steep learning curve for a country to get integrated in European Union. And that's why several people we interviewed said that what they found really useful was that prior to accession there was the stage where they could see and observe how European Union function, even though they could take no decisions in various matters, because it's not obvious the way how the European Union works, how the decisions are being made for all the countries that are willing to join the European Union, or for example the countries in Central Asia. The European Union decision making is based on a certain number of skills, a certain number of values that is not universal elsewhere, and it takes time to get used to them. And what do I mean by those values, by those skills? First of all, by observing how a European Union functions, for example, in Parliament, in Commission, in various council configurations, and even especially on the working group level, you learn the skills of cooperating, of not polarizing issues, but on cooperating, on the trying to reach consensus-based decisions. The second thing that you also learn by being an observer in various working groups and various institutions in European Union is the value of trying to build coalitions. That's also not self-evident for all the countries willing to join European Union. You also, and in my opinion, a very important thing, you also learn the value of competence, of a good argument that should be on the basis of every decision that has to be taken. You have to convince a variety of member states coming from very different perspectives, and therefore your argument should be as good as possible. And that's something that several of both people that I interviewed mentioned in this context, that at first, when still in the accession stage and during the first years of being part of European Union, they were quite silent because they didn't feel really secure that their arguments were to the same level as, for example, arguments coming from United Kingdom or for France. But they changed their procedures back at home, okay. And in the end, they learned those new qualities that you need in order to integrate successfully within the European Union. There are still some struggles. For example, still after 9-10 years after accession, there some nuances of European Union decision making is lost. But still those struggles are not as substantial as could have been imagined prior to accession. So to conclude, I would say that despite the extreme complexity of the European Union functioning, it does not take long to integrate within European Union, to understand how it works and to be quite successful within European Union. Several people from older member states have admitted that they have been very surprised in how fast the representatives, the new member states got really skilled and competent within this complex structure. Several of the best chairs of various meetings and members of parliament come from the new member states. Yes, there are some challenges, but the process itself has been impressive. And in my opinion, the main thing that could be taken from this experience and then shared with the countries that are in the accession stage and those that have some other contacts with European Union is that you shouldn't really underestimate the inspiring power of European Union to change by showing to change the practices back in those countries when they see how the things are done here in European Union. And so the focus, in my opinion, should be on building the capacity of government institutions back at home and also the civil society organizations in those countries by sharing and by the experience of European Union, by showing them here in Brussels, in other countries, how the decisions are being made, on what values are they based, and on what quality of reason, what quality of reasoning and argumentation is expected.
So, thank you.